Yes. What time did you get up this morning?
At whatever hour pleases your majesty.
We kings are always expected to know the truth. Well, for your information, you rose at 7 this morning. You went down to the park, and there you met a woman.
The queen.
The woman, sir, we will not mention by name. Now, are you a married man?
No, sire.
Good. Your future wife and children will find in me a second father. Go. I have nothing more to say to you.
You saw what I was doing? Another one, sire? More blood?
It must be.
Sire, there are already 4 who have met the queen in the park, and then 2 hours later...
4? Already?
We must stop this. Sire, you are the voice that commands, but I am the arm that executes, and I'm getting quite tired, and what's more, full of remorse.
I certainly understand.
We must stop, sire.
Just this one more, and then we will see. Now, let's occupy ourselves with the affairs of state. I believe that the conduct of my Lord Bluebeard is not clear. 5 of his 6 wives have already disappeared. It seems to me that so many crimes cannot go unpunished. 5 wives?
Yes, sire. He has caused the disappearance of 5 wives. Just like I, at your command, have caused the removal of 5...
You dare to compare the conduct of a king who rules over 20,000 men to that of a naughty little prince who has maybe 3,000 subjects?
Sire!
How dare you! You have to be ruthless. And I am ruthless.
He does have cannons, my Lord Bluebeard, while you, haven't any. I think, sire, you shouldn't be quite so ruthless with my Lord Bluebeard. Listen to him. Obey him.
Oh, very well. I'll obey him. Go, Count Oscar, and don't forget that you have a few words to say to my Lord Alvarez.
Ah, speaking of Alvarez, Count Oscar?
Your Majesty.
Tell him that I've been thinking over his request, and I think I may be able to grant it.
And to think I would have pardoned him.
As you wish, sire.
What do you wish with me, madam?
I have just been notified, as has my daughter, of how we are to spend our day.
Well?
I see that this evening at midnight she must marry the Prince Sophia.
Exactly so.
Well, sir, this marriage cannot take place.
Why? Tell me why.
I know my daughter's heart. She loves someone else.
But you can love someone and marry someone else.
Ah, I know that very well.
Madam.
I know, and you know as well, what the usual result of such a union is.
I never talk to you about that. You're always bringing it up. It isn't a suitable subject for polite conversation.
I have the right to bring it up. I have never been near enough to be guilty.
Yes, because I've always caught you just before you did something rash.
Never! And anyway, sir, you will admit that if such a case had ever occurred, the wife might have pleaded extenuating circumstances.